Hello, welcome to Delight Channel. T-Mac is my name. We have been talking about succession planning, and this week we are continuing our conversation around how do you institutionalize it. In institutionalizing it, I've already touched on 2 points. One has to do with the need for you to develop a body of business processes that will run your organization. The second is that one of the business processes you need to develop and ingrain is the succession planning business process, which basically talks about how do you identify your talent, how do you manage them, and how do you grow them such that you will always have a pool for every role in the organization. Now, the third and the last under this institutionalizing it is that you need to follow through. I have seen organizations that have done all that we've said so far. The man that owns or the leader that owns the business is ready to let go. There has been serious communication. There has been efforts to institutionalize it. But when it comes to the point of implementing, everything breaks down. Then parochial interest begins to fly in. Then subjective reasons begin to come in. And once your employees lose faith in that process, that's the end. And one thing you must not forget, and this is where most entrepreneurs miss it, is the fact that you don't own all the aces. If that talent that you have in your organization, bringing in the numbers, turning in the performances that you want, if that guy or that lady does not feel connected or looked after in that business, Mr. Entrepreneur, Miss Entrepreneur, you do not own all the aces. There may be other suitors for that employee. And you are not likely going to get the same level of respect if you are now only reacting when somebody else has made an offer or is ready to hire that talent that you have. Even if they stay to take it, their mind is that you are only reacting. Therefore, they are really never settled. That is why this is most impactful when you design it and you follow through. And I hear somebody talks about, what about my son? What about my daughter? The reason why I'm building this business is I want them to take over. You got to think again. I'm not saying don't line up your children to succeed you, but I'm saying the succession should not just happen because they're your children. How many people are following the story of Diamond Bank? I'm not going to say more than that. That's a bank in Nigeria. Go read the story. There's a lot of commentaries in the social media, online around it. A tier one bank, a few years back, is now at the point of completely disappearing of the landscape of the banking sector in Nigeria. And the major factor that has been implicated in this journey is succession. And I've read of a very successful hotelier who had a son. And that son was built and set up. Like I said, succession planning is not accidental. From day one, the boy was identified as a potential CEO to succeed his father. He was probably engaged and he was sold on that idea. And guess what? That boy, upon leaving school, worked in every single department in that hotel, from the catering to the concierge, to the reservation, to the banquet, the rooms, name it. By the time the boy was going to succeed his father, can you imagine how ready the boy would have been? There is nothing anybody can come and say that will confuse or perplex him. He's been there. He's done that. So even if you have your eyes on your children succeeding you, you will be helping them. You'll be helping yourself. You'll be helping the business when you let them go through this same succession planning process. Let them go through it. Let them earn their badge. It gives them a different layer of authority beyond being just your son. They acquire power and authority from being expert. They acquire power and authority from being respected, because they will have been seen to have paid their dues. So follow through is very, very important. Don't break it because this is my uncle's son, or this is my son, or this is my friend. Anybody that is going to get into that talent scheme or that talent program, irrespective of who or what that person is, should be through the same conditions as designed and entrenched in the process. I say it again. If you cause your employees to lose faith in the program, it is double jeopardy, because it is more difficult to rebuild that faith and that trust, and all you will then be doing will be just to react and react and react, and you will not be in a position to achieve that seamless and successful transition. So, like I said, the institutionalizing it bit is deep, is heavy. I'm just doing my best to summarize it, but that is where the rubber meets the road. And if you do it well at this point, then while you are here, while you are active, while you are strong, while you are present, you can look forward to a peaceful transition when you will be out of the system on a day-to-day basis, and you can be rest assured that the system will not only survive, it will thrive, it will flourish, and it will attain new heights. I will continue the conversation next week, and I'm hoping that you will make it a date with me. Tell your friends about the channel. Give us likes. Send us comments. Let's know you are out there, because it means everything to us knowing that we are making a difference. So, until I see you next week, if you don't know my name, T-Mac, that's it. It's not changed. And don't ever forget that all I'm trying to do is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Ciao.